Good evening students. Today in the chapter force and laws of motion we have to study the first law of motion. See here the different questions. First, who proposed the three laws of motion? Which scientist proposed the three laws of motion? What is the name of that scientist who proposed the three laws of motion? Isaac Newton is the scientist who proposed the three laws of motion. First law of motion, second law of motion, third law of motion. Which two things are considered from Galileo's experiment in Newton's three laws of motion? Whatever the three laws proposed by the Newton, that is on the basis of Galileo's experiment. So which two important things Newton taken from the Galileo's experiment in these three laws? Which two things? The first thing is force and the second thing is motion. These are the two things Newton taken from Galileo's experiment. Now the third, what is Newton's first law of motion? Which is Newton's first law of motion? In simple, this is just the general language. If anything in the rest, that object will be in the rest. If anything in the uniform motion, then that will be in the uniform motion. But at which time? Until and unless the external force is not applied on that. Till that time, that object will be in rest or in the uniform motion. This is the Newton's first law of motion. Why the Newton's first law of motion is called law of inertia? Why the Newton's first law of motion is called law of inertia? That we have to see. Newton's first law means anything in the rest, that is in the rest. Anything in the uniform motion, that is in the uniform motion. And inertia what says? The tendency of the object to resist the change in position or speed, that is called inertia. So the first law of motion is also called law of inertia. We can see that with the help of one experiment also. So we are going to see the experiment. Newton's first law of inertia. See here, this is cup I have taken and this is the card. This card I have put on this cup. And see here, this is the 5 rupees coin. I put this coin on this card. Now see, I am applying the force on this card. I am applying the force on this card. This force is not I am applying on this coin. So what happens to this coin? Result we have to see. Whether that coin goes with the card or what happens, that we have to see. See here, I am flipping this card. See here, what happened? That card due to force went away. But the coin is inside the cup. What is the conclusion of this experiment? I have applied the force on the card and this coin maintained his inertia. Force is not applied on the coin, so that coin not went with the card, but that coin falls in the cup. This is the first law of inertia. This is inertia. Okay. Now some examples of inertia. Why the sudden application of brakes may cause injury? If the car is driving and suddenly the driver applies the brake on the car, so force is applied on the car. Force is applied on your legs or whatever the sitting portion, but force is not applied on your upper body part. Force is not applied on the upper body part. So what will happen regarding the upper body part? That will go forward and we may get injury. due to our property to resist change. Our upper body part wants to maintain the inertia, and due to that this happens. Okay, now the next, why the safety belts prevent the accident? Same, when brakes are applied, we suddenly fast go ahead, but due to safety belt, what happens? Whatever our movement going forward, that becomes slow now due to safety belt. That forward motion becomes slow due to safety belt, and whatever the injury, head injury or that, that is prevented. So safety belts used. Next, why due to sudden start of a bus we tend to fall backward? You are in the bus, you are in standing position, and suddenly suppose anything came in front of the bus, and suddenly the driver applied the brake, you are in the standing position, what will happen? You will go to backward direction, and may you can fall. Why this happened? Driver applied the going car, the pressure is the car or bus applied the force due to brake, brake applied means force applied, and due to that car or bus stopped, and your legs are in that contact, your legs also stop, but your upper body part force is applied on that, brake is applied on your upper body part, no. So what will happen? This upper body part will try to maintain the inertia, and due to that what happens? You will fall in the backward direction. Now next, why you tend to get thrown to one side when motor car makes a sharp turn at a high speed? You are in the motor car, the motor car in the high speed, and suddenly driver turn the motor car to right side. What will happen? You are in that position to maintain your inertia, uniform condition, uniform position you are maintaining, and driver turn the car in right side direction. So what will happen? This is against your inertia, and you will go to left side. You will fall to opposite direction. This is also the law of inertia. Next, why only the carrot pipe at the bottom of a pile is removed when a fast moving carrot pipe or striker hits it? You know carrot pipe. With the help of that striker, that peel of the coin, the striker hits the bottom coin. Pressure is applied on the bottom coin. So all bottom coin will go ahead. And, but what the upper coins placed, that will not get in the force now. So that will not move with the bottom coin, that will fall. This is also due to the inertia. That upper coins will try to maintain their inertia and that get fall. But the bottom coin are only getting the force, that coin will go ahead. This is also the law of inertia maintained by the upper coin to be in the position, uniform position or condition. Now next, why the coin placed over the card falls in the tumbler when the card is flipped with the finger? This experiment just I have shown you. Again, once again, just in simple. This experiment I have shown you. When the coin placed over the card falls in the tumbler, when the card is flipped with the finger, what is in this experiment? Tell me.
Answer.
You have taken this conclusion. When the coin placed on the card falls in the tumbler, when the card is flipped with the finger, what is happening is, I applied the force on the card. This force is not applied on the coin. So coin falls in the cup. Why the water spills when a water filled tumbler will hold the tray and turn around as water filled tumbler you are taken and you are around as fast as circle you are making. So what will happen? Whatever the filled tumbler, the water will spill. Because the water in the tumbler will try to maintain the inertia, but due to the fast motion, the inertia of the water is changing, and due to that the water get fall. This is about the first law of motion that is included in the force and laws of motion. Thank you.